Yeah. What did you make of that, Al? What did you make of the game today?
Everything we expected, because we were playing against a very good Premier League team. We know they have a particular style of playing, and the way the player is very good. We did look at them a little bit, but we tended to focus more on us. I think, especially in the first half, we played ourselves. I think we played some good stuff. I think when they start bringing the players on, they did in the second half, and we start bringing the players on, we did in the second half, it becomes a little bit tougher. But end of the day, like I said, in the midweek game against Forest Green, it's not about sort of results. It's about getting minutes into players. So we'll not be one or two over the moon against Forest Green, and we're not too down in the dumps today. We got what we needed out of the game. The only sort of downside was the tightness that Welsh felt in his hamstring.
Yeah, hamstring, is it? I mean, has he had issues with the hamstring before, do you know?
You always tend to suffer with hamstring and calves when you come back from long-term injury, so that'll be just a consequence of that. Whether he's overcompensating for something or not, that's something we'll have to have a look at, whether that ends up being orthotics in his boots or sort of lower back or what. It could be anything. That's something that the medical department will have to look at in depth. But it's no surprise, really. It's not what we wanted, but end of the day, it's understandable with the time out that he's had over the last year.
Do you have any idea how long we got out for, or is it?
I don't think he might not be out. He was brought off because of precaution. That was all. He just felt it tighten up on the turn. So it could be that a bit of physio work on him Sunday, Monday, Tuesday will get him back in the frame for Saturday. That's certainly what we planned.
You've been here a long time now, Alan. We're a week away from the first game. There isn't a manager. Half the team have got the final, the playoff final's gone. Have you ever known it to be this bad?
I wouldn't say it's bad. I mean, that's your words, not mine. What you have seen out there is the first half, especially call it the first 60 minutes, a team that is very capable of performing in the Championship. After that is where we need the strength and depth. So to say it bad, I wouldn't go down them lines, because
I'm playing devil's advocate. If you're a fan, you're looking at it, you're thinking, oh, what's going to happen? And that's probably the thing. It's that unknown for the next week, and very capable hands in your hands at the moment. But it needs the rallying point of that new man to come in pretty quickly and then to formulate a plan. You're probably 2, 3, 4 weeks behind everyone else now, because you don't know which way you're going to be moving forward.
But what you've got to remember is this club's always embraced a challenge, and we'll continue to do that, regardless of what's happening in and around the football. We had a group of players that are very together, as you've seen today, and like I've said, yes, we need help in terms of more players coming in to stop us going so young. But what we will do is we will club together, we will stick together, there will be no excuses, and this club will always fight and face a challenge, because that's the nature of the club, that's the nature of the city, that's the nature of the people.
From a personal point of view, you know, you've had a little taste now, you've done a good job, and you know, you are, as they were shouting, a Jack through and through. A new manager comes in, does that put you in a precarious position?
No. I've spoke to Julian. I'm not going to go exactly into what we said, but I'll be involved with the first team.
We didn't see Matt Grimes today. You mentioned the other day that he was touch and go. Is there any news on him?
He came out to train the other day, wasn't feeling 100%, and because it is a pre-season game, we didn't want to take any risks with them. So we'll start looking again at Matt on Monday or Tuesday in preparation for Blackburn.
How important is he to this season? Stay, go, you know, if he stays, that could be...
If he stays, he's a fantastic player. I mean, I don't think anyone's officially come in from. I've seen a lot of paper talk around him, but there's a lot of paper talk around everyone during the off-season. When you're club captain, you obviously play a massive part on the field and off the field, and he's a terrific lad. He sets very high standards that the players follow, and he's definitely someone that I think we will be looking to keep hold of. Like I said, there's no, as far as I'm aware, there's no official bid for him. There's no bidding war, so to speak, between clubs that I know of, unless you know more than me. But we're planning for Matt to play against Blackburn.
Great. Fingers crossed. And just finally, word on Nathan Dyer?
I've known it was coming for a while. Obviously, me and Nath are quite close. We've obviously played loads of games together and coaching for 2 years, which is strange. But I used to coach him on the pitch anyway, so he was... he's a great lad. From a lovely family. Parents are great. Nath's great. Laura, his wife, are fantastic. They've got three young kids. And funnily enough, I bumped into him. I hadn't seen him for a couple of weeks, and I bumped into him in McDonald's in Morriston. And he was had the big van with him, getting a load of happy meals and that. And we had a little chat then. He let me know that he was officially going to do it. And I think he's going to be looking after the welfare of young players, or as far as I'm aware, unless that's changed. But listen, he was fantastic for us. He was great to have in the change room. He was great to play alongside on the pitch. And I'm sure he's going to enjoy retirement. And the whole club are proud of him. And I'm sure his parents are proud of him, and Laura and the kids as well.
Did you ever catch him in training or not?
The worst thing is, I think I used to follow him in the running test. You know, I was good over the long distance where I could endurance, but when it come to the sprint ones, I think he was only about a millionth of a second quicker than me.